Now let's install our Google Analytics code. And there are three main points here that you can leverage in order to install Google Analytics. The first one would be a manual installation where you find out where the template is located that places your code on all the pages and install it manually if you have a CMS. Or if you have a plain HTML site, you might need to go through each individual HTML site and implement that tracking code. The second option that is very popular are plugins, especially in the WordPress or e-commerce world. And we'll take a look on how those work. And then the newest option and the option that I really recommend is Google Tag Manager. And we'll look in how to set that up with Google Tag Manager. So let us start out with a manual installation. Back in our Google Analytics account, under the properties, so the middle here, we have the tracking information, and you can click on it and press on tracking code, which will show you your most recent tracking code. And this is the code that you should have installed on all the pages that you want to track for a basic installation of Google Analytics. So you can basically copy this. And now let's go over to our demo store. And we'll go into the backend of this WordPress installation. Here we go. And now we need to find the template that lets us install Google Analytics on all pages. So in WordPress, we go to Appearance, and here we have the editor. And then we'll find the template that is deployed on all pages. And WordPress, that's normally the header PHP. And now we can paste our code into this template. And a very important point here is that the tracking code should be installed above the closing head tag. So here we have the closing head tag, and we can just go in and paste this code. And now we can save this. And once we go on our page and reload this page, and then go into the source code, you'll be able to see that the script is installed. Also in Google Analytics, once we go back, we can reload this page and see that the tracking status says that this is not installed. This takes a little bit to update, so let's check back later. Let's go first to the reporting overview and into the real-time report. This will tell us if we are tracking any data. So let's reload this page. Go into Google Analytics. And we see a page view was just recorded and it's now recording the data. Maybe it's already updated in the admin section too. Let's go into tracking information and not yet updated. This will take a while. So let's talk really quickly about this tracking script that we just installed and the location where we installed it. We installed it above the closing head tag. Now this is pretty far up the HTML site. And this is very important that it's installed pretty far up within the HTML markup of your site. Why is this so important? Well, we want to increase the chances of the code being executed. Now, a site is normally interpreted by the browser from top to bottom. And once the browser hits this code, it will execute the Google Analytics script, which is the analytics.js, and send information over to Google Analytics. Now, a common mistake I see is that this code is actually not placed in the head, but in the footer, which is decreasing the likelihood of it being executed. Why is that? If there are any other scripts being loaded and maybe taking a while to load, the user might move on from one to the next page before the page is actually ended to load. And then the Google Analytics script obviously won't be executed and you won't get any data into your Google Analytics account. So the very important thing is to place this very up high within the document object model. Another important point here is site speed. Everybody knows that Google takes that into their ranking algorithm, and you may be concerned about when Google Analytics is firing. Google Analytics is an asynchronous script. What does that mean? Well, once the script is starting to load, the elements that lay below this Google Analytics code will simultaneously load, and it won't wait till the Google Analytics script is ready. So you don't have to worry about this code slowing down your page. Now let's talk briefly about plugins. They're very popular in the WordPress world, but also within other shop systems. There are definitely Google Analytics plugins out there. For example, for WordPress, there are many different plugins out there. I have one here installed, which is the Analytics plugin by Yoast, a very popular plugin. And all you have to do to configure it is install the plugin, and then once you are inside of the plugin, you can configure it by either directly authenticating your account with Google, which will pull in the right IDs, or to manually put in your UA tracking code. Now the UA tracking code is within the admin section and the tracking information. You'll find here this code, which most of the plugins need in order to put in the right code on that side. And then there are many different features that you can choose. Sometimes they actually go into very much detail with your CMS that you are using and can be very, very useful. The only downside that I see with these plugins, first of all, is the updatability. So if you go back to the plugin overview here, we'll see that some of these plugins haven't been updated for 2 years, which would mean that they're probably not on the most recent version of Universal Analytics code. So the most recent one would always be the one that you have in your Google Analytics account. And therefore, you need to be sure to check back if you are receiving data correctly. The real upside of these plugins is if the design changes, so the template change, you might not accidentally kick out the Google Analytics code, but the plugins will ensure that this is still installed. But plugins, of course, really are dependent on the guys who developed the plugin, on your CMS, and if it gives you all the functionality that you need to track the right things.